Well, whoa! This is the first snow. Well, I'm lying. Second snow of the season. It snowed and then it melted. We are in Northern Ontario. It's my doggies. My name is Morgan. I've decided to start a YouTube channel. Well, sorry, me and my boyfriend decided to start a YouTube channel of our snowmobiling adventures. And my first video I'm going to make today is just a video on the gear that I've decided to use this year. And, well, the start of it anyways, because I'm sure that'll change throughout the year, but... So anyways, this might be a little awkward, because I'm not used to filming myself. Don't, Shadow, do not go in there. Hey, you guys, come here. Come on. My dogs want to go in the creek back there. I'm going to go inside and I'm going to show everybody my stuff. Let's go. All right, let's get started. So we'll start first, I guess, on my helmet. So this helmet I've had since 2020, I think I got it. It's a 2020 Titan, DKX Titan. Love the Titan helmets. They're modular. I don't know, I'm sure most of you know what they are, but if you don't, your goggles are attached. So, get that. And that. Let me just calm my dogs down because they're making a lot of noise. I'll be back. Alright guys, here we are again. So, I went to go edit my footage and realized that I must have deleted the first part of my video, so here we are again. So, the footage I deleted, I talked about my helmet, kind of, my boots, my chest protector, and my backpack, and my gloves, etc., etc. So, actually, I think I did talk about my helmet a little bit in the first part of the video, so we should be good there. I just kind of mentioned I do love the CKX Titan. It's a great helmet. The color. Oh, well, hello there. You gonna sit? You be my co-host? Sprocket's joining. So I was just kind of mentioning how the color I love, I actually based my wrap off of it. So once I have everything on, I'm gonna go out and show you guys my sled and all my stuff. So I did talk about this. So last year I kind of bought these boots on a whim. I was at a local dealership and I seen they had them. So I bought them. So these are the FXR Explorer boot. A lot of you may have seen these. There's the tall version and the short versions. I got the short ones. I think they've been pretty good. I wore them most of the season last season. They are quite warm as long as you wear good, decent socks with them. They have this little cup. I don't know. You can adjust it so no snow can get in there, although you would have your ski pants and that would help, or your monosuit would help cover. But yeah, they've been good so far. I like them. I have no complaints. I think they'll probably last me another couple years. Or, well, this year for sure. Maybe next year too. We'll see. So another item that I bring on most of my rides would be my backpack. I always keep extra pair of gloves in here for the ride home if I need them or something happens. So extra pair of gloves. My balaclava in case I get cold, but most of the time I don't need this unless it's a really cold day. Usually I'm okay in just my helmet because just the way I ride, right? I get pretty sweaty. Yeah, drinks, snacks, just a few little things that I throw in there. Yeah, I don't know. It's a great backpack. I don't use that. There's like a little spot for a water bottle. Lots of little nooks and crannies in here actually, but yeah, no, I have no complaints. I like it. I'll continue to be using it. So yeah, the balaclava I'll use on a cold day. I'm pretty lucky that, I shouldn't say I'm pretty lucky. We get really cold weather here, like lots of minus 20, minus 25, minus 30 days, but I usually don't ride those days. I usually ride in the minus 10, minus 5, minus 10, minus 15. Those are my kind of days. But I still have the balaclava. Also really lucky that where I live, you know, obviously I'm in Northern Ontario. I don't have to worry about avalanches and stuff like that, so. Yeah, I don't have to have any avalanche gear or anything. I did, however, this year purchase a chest protector. Just getting a little bit more brave in our adventures, and I want to do more things, and I just feel that I'll have more confidence if I have some type of protection, like if I hit a rock or if I hit a tree or anything like that. I don't want to be going into the handlebars, and I had a couple close calls last year, so I decided to get this. I did try it on with my mono suit, and I did find it felt a little bit bulky. Once I had my backpack on and it tied around me, it felt a little bit better. So we'll see once the season starts how I like it, but I think it will give me that little extra boost of confidence that I need. So, update you guys as the season progresses on the chest protector anyways. And yeah, so in my next clip, I talk about my base layers. I talk about my mono suit. So we'll get to that. And then I'm gonna try everything on. We're gonna go outside, look at the snowmobile, and look at, I don't know, nothing. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, see you there. Okay, friends, let's talk mono suits, let's talk base layers. I'm silly, and all last season I didn't wear any base layers. Well, I did. They were like Under Armour, just leggings, like nothing actual base layers. So anyways, this year I just got these Polaris ones. So I'm excited to try them out. Hi, Sprocky. Hi, puppy. Do you like my base layers? Okay, Sprocket's decided to join us. So I got the pants in a small, and I find they're a little loose up here for some reason, but that's okay. The top's great. I love it. I can try and show you guys. So you can see, that there's some fuzz. Some fuzz there to keep you warm. So yeah, so I can't really give you guys, you know, any reviews on the base layers currently because I haven't tried them yet. But they feel great so far. I'm sure they're great. It's Polaris, so they must be awesome. So yeah, this is my mono suit. It's the CKX Evolution. It's a non-insulated one. Mono suits are amazing. If you don't have a mono suit, I would definitely recommend trying them out. Best thing ever. This suit in particular has removable knee pads, so there's some padding in there. It has the drop seat, so if you need to go potty when you're out in the backcountry or in the mountains, or on the trails, I suppose, you can unzip it and do your business. So that's great. Just wonderful. I did use it once last year, and it was wonderful. Yeah, so I guess I could also mention it has a hood. I know some mono suits, you see, they don't have hoods, but removable hood, so you can take it on or off. I love the color black. Black with, you know, this little gray on the knee, and of course the pink accents. Like I said earlier, my sled wrap has a similar raspberry purpley color to my helmet. So I was hoping to get a mono suit with something like that, but no luck. It just has the pink stripe. So, but that's okay. That's all right. So guys, I'm going to get my mono suit on. Actually, I'm going to get all my gear on. I'm going to take you outside and we'll stand in front of my snow machine and show you all my stuff on. Hi guys. my stepson's out on his new snowmobile. He just bought a, he bought himself a 2013 Summit, I think. There he is out there. He's super excited. Anyways, I forgot to mention my gloves. So I'm just gonna do a quick little glove thing. So I'm getting my mono suit on for you guys. And I just wanted to show you, so I got these FXR, they're just little cheapy gloves. I'm thinking I'm gonna get a pair of heated gloves this year, so I was thinking Climb or 509. If any of you have a heated pair of gloves, let me know. Is it worth it? These little cheapy FXR gloves that I got, they get wet, they get cold. It's no fun, so I definitely need something better, but I'm obviously going to be spending money on the gloves, so let me know what you guys like. I want the heated ones, though, so if you like the heated ones, let me know if they're worth it. Thanks! Guys, so we got the sleds out. Okay, and here's mine, like I was saying. So the wrap is by eSticky. They make awesome wraps. I always want to switch mine up, but I'm not going to. So I'll put my helmet on, my backpack on, and I'll show you everything together. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I just wanted to film a little outro. Thanks for watching if you've made it this far. I myself enjoy gear videos a lot, and I know that we're limited on the female gear, so I'm really hoping that my girlies out there watched the video and enjoyed it, and it's nice to see other people wearing different gear and some reviews. So I'll keep you updated as the season progresses. We're excited to get out on the sleds. Probably won't be for another month or so now for good snow anyways, but we're hoping. Now I'll be obsessing over the weather and looking at the weather radar all the time. Anyways, hope you guys liked the video. Leave a like, subscribe. There's more to come for sure. You'll be seeing more of Trevor. You'll probably see some of Kian, maybe even my other stepson, Jace. Kian's the one who got the Summit. Jace doesn't have a snow machine, but I'm sure he'll still come on some rides with us. So yeah, we will see you next time.